Hey, check this out.
Those are microplastics, but the vast majority don't come from beads and facial scrub. They come from our clothing, tires, water bottles, and the million other things we make out of plastic. Microplastics pose a threat to our ocean and other waterways, as well as the life that depends on them, including us. And this magnetic liquid may just be the solution for getting it out, or at least a solution. I want to say up front that by far the greatest threat of plastic ending up in our planet's water is the fact that we just keep producing tons of it and extracting the fossil fuels that make plastic possible. And to make matters worse, most of us think of plastic as disposable. Heck, expressly disposable things like cutlery are usually made out of plastic. So this problem won't be anywhere near solved until we can cut ourselves off from plastic. That being said, we currently produce over 300 million tons of plastic waste each year. So there's a lot of plastic that has made its way to our waterways and ocean. Despite the headline-grabbing garbage patches in the ocean, it's not those large pieces of plastic trash that pose the biggest hurdle to removing plastic from the ocean or other waterways. Or at least not yet. Exposure to waves, wind, and sunlight break larger plastics down into smaller and smaller pieces. But unlike many other materials that may end up in the water or soil, nearly no microorganisms can break plastic down. So plastic we throw out can stick around for potentially thousands of years or longer. Getting those big pieces of plastic out of the water isn't exactly easy. There are many projects working on removing it, but it's expensive and can sometimes do more harm to the marine life we're purportedly saving from the plastic. But how do you remove millions of tons of tiny pieces of plastic that are 5 millimeters in size or smaller? That's the problem of microplastics. One of the most popular tactics is developing plastic-eating bacteria, which there has been some success with, but isn't ready to work at scale. There are a ton of videos on YouTube about that already, but I recently came across a really interesting approach to microplastics removal I'd never heard of that I needed to talk about. And it was invented by this Irish teenager, Fionn Ferreira. Fionn figured out how to use what's called a ferrofluid to extract microplastic from water. He won a Google Science Fair award for it at 18 in 2019, but apparently started working on this when he was 12. Growing up near a shore where lots of plastic trash ends up on the beach, he heard about and became concerned about microplastics at a young age. This tiny plastic gets eaten by fish and other marine life and can block their digestive tracts and even make them feel full, which can starve them to death. And much of the seafood we eat, even the farmed ones, are full of plastic too. We know that the stuff plastic is made of is not safe to ingest, but it's unclear if the amount that gets in us is negligible to our health. Unlike with animals, we can't exactly feed someone plastic and find out, but with more and more plastic ending up in our water, more and more is ending up in us. We're still very much figuring out the extent of the harm microplastics are creating for us and ocean life. But a study by the University of Newcastle found that just by drinking water or even beer and eating stuff like shellfish and salt, we're ingesting 5 grams of plastic every week. That's like eating a credit card every week. I actually have a much better suggestion for storing your credit cards. Just use NordPass, this video's sponsor. It remembers all your credit card details and passwords for you, so you can easily autofill on your computer or phone. You can also generate unique and safe passwords for every website you visit. So you don't have to compromise security because you can't keep track of dozens of passwords. And NordPass has a ton of other features, like constantly scanning the dark web to see if your passwords or credit card info has been leaked, or letting you safely share passwords with friends and family. Honestly, it's not an exaggeration to say that I can't go back to the internet without a password manager. If you want to join me in the safe and lazy password manager club, go to nordpass.com/futurenow or use code FUTURENOW. During their special Cyber Month deal, you can get 70% off NordPass plus an additional month for free until the 1st of December 2021. That's pretty sweet. Thanks, NordPass. Right, Fionn and his invention. So, one of the wildest parts of his story is that according to him, living in a particularly remote part of Ireland meant he didn't have access to many scientific tools, so he decided to build them himself. He very casually explains in some interviews that he built his own spectrometer in a wooden box to measure microplastic density. Apparently, he got his idea for the ferrofluid invention when he found some plastic attached to spilled oil on a beach shore. From there, he found research by physicist Arden Werner, who, after seeing news of the BP oil spill, discovered a novel way of cleaning up oil spills. Werner realized that he could mix iron shavings with oil and then use a magnet to pull both the shavings and the oil attached to it out of the water. So Fionn thought, hey, why not see if you can mix oil and iron shavings with water containing microplastics and pull everything but the water out with a magnet? He ran a test and it seemed to work. Then he ran 5,000 more using a variety of different kinds of microplastics, including from car tires and polyester clothing fibers, and meticulously counted the amount of plastic in the water using his homemade spectrometer. In the end, he found his method was 87% effective at removing microplastics and is currently working on developing a larger scale prototype. This method could also be used to create water filters for water management to remove microplastics as they flow through, or even installed in washing machines, which add a surprising amount of microplastics to our water from our clothing. Of course, when I saw Fionn doing what seemed like a fairly simple experiment at home, I had to try it out. And it didn't really work out for me. I didn't have time to figure it out before putting this video together, so here are the results of what I actually got to. I have the iron fillings and I have some oil. I don't think I had small enough microplastic. I'll leave this one to the experts.